Welcome to Soundblots, the ISR podcast. Today we are with Professor Andronikof, Emeritus Professor of the University of Paris 10, Paris Nanterre, former President of the ISR, former editor of the Rorschachiana, and a very well-known personality in the Rorschach world. Thank you for this time, and how are you?
Thank you very much. I'm very honored to be invited to this meeting and podcast.
Thank you. Tell me, when did you find the Rorschach? At what moment in your life, of your studies?
I met the Rorschach the third year of the university. In France, it is the level of the licence. I guess it's the equivalent of the Bachelor of Art in the other countries. So I met it in a small group of people, and I was introduced to the Rorschach through Lusli Usteri, her writings with the Rorschach with children, etc. And I was absolutely fascinated by the cards, the aesthetical dimension of the Rorschach cards, and by possibilities of understanding a personality, a functioning that it gave us. So after the third year, when I entered in for the master degree, I continued. I chose Rorschach seminars.
With whom did you study Rorschach? Who were your professors?
At first, I studied the Rorschach with two professors from Paris 5, the Institute of Psychology. It was Professor Matikiva, whom nobody knows him today. And the other one was Professor Nina Rausch de Traubenberg. And my third teacher in Rorschach was John Exner.
When did you find John Exner, the comprehensive system?
Well, that's a very funny story, because when I was preparing my doctoral dissertation in 1980-81, I was pushed by Nina Rausch de Traubenberg to present my study at the International Congress in Washington, D.C. So I sent a submission, and I had analyzed the Rorschach of diabetic children, and with the French system, of course, with the, not the today, the French system today, but the French system of Nina Rausch de Traubenberg, which was a sort of mix between quantitative good scoring, quantitative data, and qualitative understanding of the responses. So I went to Washington to present my study, and somebody made an error, and I was put into the main hall instead of being in a little side room like usual. So I was put into the main room with interpretation into four languages. So I presented my study, and at the end of my presentation, someone came to me and said, well, that was interesting, but unfortunately, completely invalid. So that was terrible for a student like I was to have presented invalid studies. And I said, what do you mean invalid? And who are you? And he said, why didn't you code your Rorschach, with the comprehensive system? And I said, with what? And he said, I'm John Exner, and I'm going to teach you the comprehensive system. And after that, he came the next month, he came to Paris, and he spent 2 weeks teaching me the comprehensive system. But as I was working during the daytime, I had a job, we worked at night. So I spent 15 nights with John Exner learning the comprehensive system. Then he took, and we coded all of my protocols. And he took the results of the scorings. He went back to the United States and he said, I'm going to see if statistically, if there is any sense in what you did and in your hypothesis. And 1 week later, I received a telegram. That was the time when there was no iPhones and no SMS, nothing like that. So I received a telegram from him, which I hope I kept somewhere. And in this telegram, it was saying, wonderful, all your hypotheses are demonstrated. So you do understand that after that, I thought that the comprehensive system was an excellent system. And what is interesting is that when I, before knowing about the comprehensive system, when I scored my protocols, I had created some personal codings. For instance, for the reflection, for the form dimension, things like that. And then I discovered it was in the comprehensive system. So there was the reason why I adopted the comprehensive system. And this is a very sweet anecdote.
And then what happens later? Because at the beginning you were working with Nina Roche and you published many interesting papers around the body and a kind of
a scale of
la representation de soi, of self-representation. Mm-hmm. And also about the body. I remember some papers written by you, published in the Psychologie Française, really a very good paper around the body and the Rorschach. Can you tell us something around that, or that period of your work?
Yes, certainly. It's, of course, a long time ago, but I still have the opinion that the body of a person is concerned, is projected, we might say, into the Rorschach inkblots. And this is through the axis of symmetry that is in the middle. And there is a sort of mirror identification between the subject who looks at the cards and the structure of the inkblots. And it's extremely interesting because through that projection, identification, you can see how the psychological structure of the person, how it is represented, and how solid it is or how vulnerable it is through the responses in the Rorschach. And we studied mainly the contents through the contents of the cards. And there was, before that, there was a, you know, the famous Fisher and Cleveland study on barriers and penetration, the scores. And there's a lot of interesting thing, yes. And there's a lot of interesting things there. And we tried to expand this, all these ideas. And I think the responses in the Rorschach are a sort of reflection of the, how should I say, the ego of the subject, the person, its structure, its balance or unbalance, etc., things like that.
In that period of your life, among all those research you have done around the body, which are the research you remember more, you like the most?
Well, I don't know if I'm going to respond directly to your question, but there is this famous, I wrote an article about it, the famous case of this young boy of 14 who was sent to me for an assessment because he was a psychotic child. And he was in an institute for psychotic children since the age of 5 years old. And he arrived at an age where this institution could not keep him anymore. So the question was, to what institution can we send him now? So I assessed this boy, and he gave a Rorschach that did not look at all like the psychotic Rorschachs that I had seen before. So I thought, he's not psychotic. What is he? What is happening to him? And this was a very bizarre protocol, with extremely bizarre, with some blocks in his speech, the things that he saw, and so much suffering he was expressing in his Rorschach. Not at all like a psychotic person. So I asked for him to have an IRM, a PET scan of the brain, and they did it. The psychiatrist with whom I was working accepted this hypothesis, and he sent the boy to a PET scan, and the results were extraordinary because he had a very particular damage of the brain, agenesis of the callus corpus, which meant that the right hemisphere and the left hemisphere were not in contact with each other. So this confirmed that the body speaks in the Rorschach.
Thank you. It's very interesting. So you started more or less in the 80s, scoring with coding with a comprehensive system.
Yes.
And then you kept comprehensive system, and you discarded the old systems or the former systems. And what was your development later, after this first part of your studies and research around the body and all that?
Well, you see, I don't think it is necessary to discard other methods, other systems, other approaches to the Rorschach, because what the comprehensive system gives us, it gives us a very solid way to code the responses. It's a scoring system that includes all the scorings that are possible and that had been described before. So if you want to measure something in the Rorschach, then I think this is the best possible method, the comprehensive system, for that. And you can also interpret the responses. After you have interpreted it within the comprehensive system, you can add other approaches. You can add other clinical readings of the responses. It is not incompatible at all. So, to go back to your question, after that, I, of course, used the Rorschach comprehensive system, adding other things to it. Every time I had to assess a person in the hospital, in a psychiatric hospital, in the somatic ward where I was working. For instance, I had to deal with make a study about children who do not grow normally. Children who stay very little, very small. There was a book called Slow Grows the Child. And it was a big questioning in the medical aspect, in medical approach of children. Why do they don't grow? Some of them, of course, have some biological problem which can explain that they don't grow. But some others don't have anything that is showing in their body. And it was discovered that some children that are ill-treated don't grow, stop growing. So the question was, and it is called in French, it is nanisme psychosocial. It's a dwarfism. These are dwarfs, children who have a dwarf size, which is apparently caused by ill treatment from their parents. But it's a very special ill treatment. It's a psychological, these are children who, and it's sometimes one child in a not their sisters and brothers, but just this one child who is completely, whose existence is denied by the parents. So the question for us was how to distinguish. Can we have a way to distinguish between the children who have a biological problem and the children who do not have it and could have a ill-treating diagnosis? And I used two tools, psychological tools, to try to help this distinction, the Rorschach test and the Ray figure test. And with the Ray figure, I could distinguish 90% of the cases. And with the Rorschach, I came to 85% of the cases.
That's curious. Yeah.
Ray and Osterate, which...
I know. I use it.
So yes.
The Ray Osterate.
Ray Osterate.
Yeah. Okay.
Which has two forms, one for children after 7 years old, I think. And the other, yes. And the other for children that are younger children.
I see. And in which way did you see in the Ray Osterate the problem?
I don't remember exactly.
Okay. That's
but I had a scale because
there's a scale.
Yes. I applied the scale that I had created because in some of the reproductions, the drawings of the Ray figure by these children had very specific characteristics, very bizarre, very, and all these children who had biological problems, they did the same error, same kind of error. But I don't remember exactly which it was now. Or
it's okay.
Today.
And then, which were your subjects of research after this period of studying and working on the body and the psychological matters?
Well, after that, I created in the university a research center that was focused on the relationship between the body and the psyche. So I tried to study the processes of the health processes and the disease processes. What happens inside a person when this person is building his health, and what happens when the health is damaged, etc., both on a somatic level and a mental level. So I studied psychopathology and some somatic illnesses in parallel. With the Rorschach. But finally, I became an expert witness for the courts in France. In France, it is a very special procedure. You have to apply, you have to be recognized as someone who is able to, who is competent by the peers, and then you are allowed to make assessment for the court. So I became expert witness. And why did I apply for that? It was because I wanted to test the Rorschach. Will the Rorschach give us interesting information in this area? And then I, for 20 years, I assessed. I worked only in the penal system for crimes and all the crimes that you can imagine of, including murders and pedophilia, etc. And I always tested them with the Rorschach test. And I I'm sure you know the article I published about the murders, Scénario Privé. And this is probably the research that is that I consider as the most profound and the most interesting of all the research I've done before.
Yeah, I see. And it was quite quoted, that paper written by you. In France, at least, I know other authors that has referred to that paper. And tell me, in which way do you see the future of the Rorschach?
Well, as you know, I don't think the Rorschach exists. What I mean is that I don't know what the Rorschach is. We have hundreds of methods, existing methods for the Rorschach cards. So what is the future? We could focus on one method or the other method and try to think what is the future, what is the future of this particular method. But the Rorschach in general, I cannot know. I don't know what it is.
Well, I know. I think I can give a response on that, but it's not in this moment. So please, in which way do you think the future of the comprehensive system?
Well, the future, what I see is that it will largely depend on the freedom, the liberty that will be given to the psychologists in their practice, in their work. What I mean is that more and more psychologists, clinicians, are bound to reduce the time they spend with their clients, are bound to be productive. And this is contrary to clinic, to the real practice of a clinical approach, trying to understand a person who is sick, who has a disease, trying to understand how he came to become like that and how to help him bringing back his health. So I think we need time. So the future of psychological assessment or the future of the Rorschach included in a psychological assessment will depend on the capacity of the clinicians to fight for their position, for the what they think, and what they and their willingness to continue being real clinicians. As you know, this problem of the clinical approach is also true in medicine. And more medicine, beginning in the United States, has become a sort of check these scales and interpret an image, a radio, a photograph, interpret the results of the blood analysis, etc. And this is not clinical. And in the United States, a few years ago, I have seen an announcement in the New York Times saying the Faculty of Medicine in the United States is searching old doctors, old physicians, because we have lost the clinical sense. We don't know anymore how to do clinics. So please, you old physician, can you please come and teach us and show us how to do it? And the same is going to happen for psychologists. So this is my worry, a big worry for that. If a psychologist can defend their field, then I think the Rorschach test with the comprehensive system, or with another one, if one better system is found. I don't know of any better system yet, but it might be possible that a better system would be invented. So I think then the Rorschach has an extraordinary, interesting future.
Thank you very much for this wonderful time and so many interesting and more than interesting, fascinating ideas.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.